Okay guys, so we're gonna have a go at tying a Perdigon Nymph. So I picked up a second-hand fly tying kit off eBay about a month ago, and I've been having a little play. It hasn't gone the best, but I guess you've got to start somewhere. So I think I've just decided to put a video up with this one. Now this is not a tutorial because I'm nowhere near skilled enough to do that. It's just more of a video of my journey and how my fly tying is coming along. So let's see how we get on. So we're going to start with, I've got a size 12 with a bead on the top. I'm not quite sure what size bead, it just was in one of the kits that I've come and there was no sizings on it. So the thread we're going to be using is from Max Catch. It's called the Sincere Offer in the Royal Sissy. I don't know what that means, but we're going to give it a go, and it's going to be in black. So I'm just going to start it off there. I'm not going to put a big head on it. Just there, I'm just going to chop that bit off. I'm going to find my scissors. Okay, and then for the tail feathers we're going to be using Coq de Lion. So we're going to take out, I don't know, I think we need many of them. These are pretty expensive. I bought these off eBay again, or Amazon, I can't remember which one. About 12 quid for a small bunch of feathers. So we're going to take, I don't know, I don't need many, I don't believe. That price anyway, let's try 4 or 5. Peel them off. Okay, I think we want these about there. Try and hold it in place. Let's just spin this around. Try and get a flat edge. Come over loosely. Position, let's have a look at that. I think that's good. Put a couple of turns on that one. There we go. That's good. I think, I don't know. Just chop this excess off. There we go, looking good. Okay, next we're gonna take some flash. What we got? Yeah, we got a bit of green here. So let's take this piece. Just chop this section off. So we got green or should we go silver? Let's go green, crystal flash. Okay, and then what we're gonna do with this is we're gonna try and put that to the side. Try and sit it as close into the bead as I can. I've probably got too fat of fingers for this. It's quite a delicate operation this. I probably haven't got the smallest of hands, but you know what? Okay, I'll just spin this around a flat now. Okay, in. Let's have a look at the position. Looks good. I've already got a small tape of that building here. That's what I wanted. Halfway down the hook, I think. There we go, that's looking good. That is looking good. Okay, now we're going to flatten this out again and we're going to take it back up. I'm just going to put a slight taper on it again. That will seat that bead in nicely, I hope. Down, spin, back up. There Okay, now I'm going to tie this off. I don't have a whipping tool yet, so I'm just using the half inch knot. Why I'm taking this off is I want to add a hot spot, and a hot spot I'm going to use a different color. Okay, so now we've got our bright orange on. I'm just going to put that on there and make our hot spot. Snip that off. There. Okay. Just leave that dangling, and now we will take our flash and make tight turns around, overlapping. Step up too big. That's okay. Okay, that's good. I think now I'm going to put one on that side and one on this side, one on that side, and one on this side, and that should hold it in place. We'll snip this off as close as we can. That's not good. Okay, we might be able to save that though, because I'm just about to put a half inch in it anyway. I can get away with a small half inch because I'm going to be putting in just about. Okay, I think that's pretty good. Okay, so next I'll take a UV resin. To be honest, this hasn't worked too well for me when I've been learning this. I found it's been putting it on too thickly. Let's have another go. Okay. Let's get some on there. Okay, that's not too bad. Careful not to touch the tail feathers. Okay, that's not too bad actually. I've got a cocktail stick here. And what I'm going to do with that now is just rub that over. Just to make sure it's not too thick anyway. That actually looks okay. Right, and take my UV torch. This one is from Tronix Pro for sea fishing. It works. Give it a blast. looking good. Okay, so final step is a 4x. And this I'm using some black fly tying varnish. I'm gonna use my cocktail stick for this. Oh, got a bit OTT there. Didn't need a little bit. In we will. Soak into the bead. And I've got no way to put this. Let's have a look what we've got here. But I don't want getting covered in ink. I've got my little mat here. My little max catch mat. Let's put that there. Okay guys, and we'll give that another zap. And that is done. I'm actually quite happy with the way that's turned out. I will flatten the barb down a bit later. Now, some of the videos I've watched when they tie these, they do add a little bit of clear varnish over the top, again just to protect it. But I don't know if it's needed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this one without, and then the next one I tie, I'm going to add a bit of cement to it, and then we'll compare them and see if it does make any difference. Ah, excellent. Well, that went better than I expected, I must admit. Yeah, fantastic. Okay, well, thanks for joining. If you have made it this far, please leave a comment and a like. I'll see you on the next video. Thanks all.